Come on.
If it doesn't fit, you take photos and send it to them, which is what I did.
Yes.
And then there was one dress that really didn't work out. And I sent it back to them in full credit. And they really, I wonder what they would do with me if I had one, you know, I had a big curve. So that's one side of me. But there are like 1,000 dresses, and I can help you navigate the website. See, I know where to go for my classes. Are you here?
Unbelievable. Yes.
I am.
Oh, it's just right.
We had dinner together.
Yeah.
How cute are you? I guess they were getting impatient with us.
I think so.
Right. Wait, let me just finish my steps.
I remember
the text.
I'm sorry about today, Karen. We talk almost every day. The dogs were barking. What was I speaking about? I don't remember. And we've gone down this path for all the years we've worked together in the office. And it's like we both have seen it.
Yeah.
And we both backtracked. Anyway, yes, and I think also this is going to be
The only thing is that maybe some people still are coming. If we're about to start, then you better move down.
They have loose fitting.
Tell them that to be prepared to go back and forth.
Well, it's more of a length.
Anyway,
like,
this is what I wanted to know. You can find out. This dress. You pick the sleeve type, and they have sometimes
me. guess you're going to see. Don't start it before we have even started to complain.
We only have time for a sound check.
Just give me a second.
I didn't think so.
We did the sound check. We did the sound check with Galena. I don't have anything to give you right now. What would you like?
Just a test.
I don't have anything to give you.
Oh, okay.
Thank you. Good evening, and welcome back to the Apollo Arts Summer Festival. Tonight's production of Cinderella is based on the Rodgers and Hammerstein musical and is especially designed for the young and young at heart. For the first time, we have live musical accompaniment throughout the production from Moran Evan. And we received support from the community, too numerous to mention. It took the entire village. Thank you to Apollo Arts members who made this production possible. And if you're not yet a member, please consider doing so. Mark your calendar for September 3rd and 4th, when Peter Lau will be returning to the stage, and then with the following week with his friend and colleague Dmitry Kosov. Please take a moment to make sure that your cell phones do not sound, and prepare to be enchanted.
Where shall I begin?
Begin at the beginning, go on till you come to the end, then stop.
Well done. So, let's have a fairy story.
Fairy story?
You know, a story that...
My dad has a suspicion.
Oh no, not a lie. Make believe.
But what if we don't believe you?
Oh.
Sometimes it's not have to be true to be real. Sometimes it's more fun if it's not real. It's only a paper moon sailing over a cardboard sea, but it wouldn't be make-believe if you believe in me. It's only a canvas sky hanging over a muslin tree, but it wouldn't be make-believe if you believe in me. Without your hearts, it's a honky-tonk parade. Without your minds, it's a melody played in a penny arcade. It's a Barnum and Bailey world, just as phony as it can be. But it wouldn't be make-believe if you believe in me. Without your hearts, it's a honky-tonk parade. Without your minds, it's a melody played in a penny arcade. It's a Barnum and Bailey world, just as phony as it can be. But it wouldn't be make-believe if you Let's tell the story of Cinderella. We need someone to play Cinderella as a young girl. Are you sure, Roland?
Well, I am very pretty looking.
Well, let's wait and see.
What about us?
Oh, you get to play brave mice.
Mighty Mouse.
Yes, look at the costumes we've got for you. And we've got some mouse heads as well. Pringle, you will play Cinderella's happy little fox friend. Oh, perfect. Now, let's see. Odie, you're gonna be a grumpy pumpkin.
No problem.
Well, in the story, you get transformed into a golden carriage.
I can handle it.
Now, let's see. Cinderella as a young girl. Amy.
Me?
Yes, good. And the prince when he's a boy, Roland.
That means he's prettier than me.
Perfect. That's settled now. Okay. You've all got your costumes. You've all got your parts. Are you ready? But who's everybody else going to play?
They play the audience!
Positions, everyone! Wait! Someone's missing!
Ah! I've been watching! Hello! Here's my... Thank you, dear.
Dear fairy godmother, would you be willing to work a little...
Make-believe!
You mean... Magic children, let's all go around. Morning.
Good morning, Fairy Godmother.
Good morning, Ella.
Well done, Fairy Godmother.
It's a pleasure.
Lived in their cottage.
Without a care in the world.
Except in caring for each other.
Look. It's magical. This
green is lost in care.
Let's walk to this bench. So time passed, and the seasons changed. Thank you.
morning, Father.
Ella, my dear, I don't have time. Ella! Please, don't make so much noise.
It's just fun, Father.
You have a wild streak, Ella. It needs taming.
If a broken clock is right twice a day, then how are we supposed to know when it's
breakfast time?
2 times 2 equals 22.
Is that a carrot from the palace? Pringle, what? Go outside, why?
This clock really needs cleaning.
What would one's royal father say?
Come and look for yourselves then.
What are we so excited about?
It's a magic garden.
No. It's an English garden. And therefore wild. We wouldn't want anything like that at the palace. Now, come down, look at your trousers.
Some interesting news to report, Father.
What is it, Ella, my dear?
I just met the prince.
I don't have time.
Do you think we have a magic garden?
Well, your mother thought so.
We should invite the prince to tea. He seems lonely.
What a wild idea.
I could write to the palace. Or you could.
Well, let me think about it when I have more time.
So Ella grew into a lovely young woman.
Father, Father, time for a lovely breakfast.
It's the middle of the morning, Ella, my dear. I don't have time.
Well, as you always say, if we don't have time, make time.
What a lovely growl that has.
Indeed, Mama.
We might find them all, and with a tiny conversion, turn them into a fashion emporium.
Oh, poor Pringle, another grown-up.
Just push! Oh, how wonderfully forceful you are, Mama.
A force of nature, Mama.
What are you?
My name is Ella.
Is that all?
Getting to the point, aren't we? Kudos, Mama. Do I smell a rat?
Oh, he's absolutely not a rat. Shall I serve tea?
Yes. 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 I want a 30-minute pudding in 20 seconds.
And a chocolate mini cake in 30 seconds.
Well, how about rose-flavored macaroons?
Oh, it has no taste, and therefore a complete waste of time.
Obviously an underprivileged thing. Who owns this fine little cottage, dear?
My father. He's the Royal Time Engineer.
Oh, your mother must be so proud.
She was, but she died, ma'am.
Oh. Your father, is he at his place of business?
No, he's in there in his workshop.
All the luck in the world, Mama.
Waste not a moment, Mama.
Hello?
No time, no time.
Shy, introverted estate collector.
Oh, sensibly cautious.
Oh, thank goodness, not a hobbyist, or we'll never get him out of there.
Oh.
You're alive. Apparently sane, and quite presentable.
Madam? Pleased to meet you.
Oh. Take it, you have some
skill in the raising of children.
Yes, it's mastery, sir. One treats them both as bane and blessing. Oh, I should have called them that. Oh, won't you come in?
Oh, yes, thank you.
We know what you're thinking.
Both of us and at the same time. And my mind's a blank. How about more tea?
Oh, don't look, it's not there. What can Wood call you?
Ella.
That's not already your name.
Dirty.
And smudgy.
And obviously.
Ugly. Oh, charming. Look at your apron.
What a disgrace.
And these smudges in your face.
All over your face.
I know, cinders.
Ella Cinders.
Cinderella.
Oops. Girls, and you, this fine gentleman and I have decided to become
partners. Oh. Father?
She has such wonderful force of character, Ella. It'll be good for your discipline, my dear.
I do recommend a few rearrangements about the house.
Rearrangements?
Of course. Quickly, girls. And of course there is a matter of a small contract.
Well, I'm insured for time loss and time waste.
My room! You best, this is my room.
Oh.
Pringle, they're in my room. Help me think.
Your bedding, your closet.
That's it, girls. We shall now marry instantly.
Oh.
Cinderella, my veil.
Cinderella, my bouquet. Cinderella, the bell.
Ella, dear, my top hat.
Do we do?
We do.
It's done. And away we go.
Oh, Ella, wind up my cloaks and look after the house.
Large shoes.
Oh, girls. You know, I could deliver him home immediately, but he probably wouldn't even notice. But let me be clear, as soon as we get home, he will be abundantly clear about who is the head of this household.
Yes, yes, Mama.
Turn left at the desert. Come along. Come here.
Coming, dear.
Event, but I don't know what it is.
You have alarming foresight, Mama. Often noted. And admired.
Well, tea is wonderful for calming excitable nerves. Mm.
Didn't I tell you, girls? Oh. News. Great news. Let's see. Grab it. Get it. Mary. Here, dear. Great news. Everyone.
The prince is giving a ball. The prince is giving a ball. The prince is giving a ball. His Royal Highness Christopher Rupert, Vendemir Vladimir, Carl Alexander, Francois Reginald, Lancelot Herman.
Herman.
Gregory James is giving a ball. The prince is giving a ball.
The prince is giving a ball.
The prince is giving a ball.
The prince is giving a ball.
Oh, listen, everyone, listen. By order of His Rightful Highness, the prince of here and everywhere, all eligible maidens are invited to the palace ball tomorrow night at 9 p.m. precisely. The prince is giving a ball!
Ella, dear, is that a summons from the palace?
Yes, I've just been invited to the palace ball.
We've all been invited, dear.
Well, that's marvelous, Ella. Your mother and I met at the ball.
I have other ideas, dear. The house is filthy, and there's still sand in our packing cases from the pyramid.
Really? Have a wonderful time, Ella. Perhaps your stepsisters want to join you. And now, if you'll excuse me, madam, I must attend to the time.
Oh, did he not read his contract? This invitation is not for you.
Mama's right. We'll show you. She wrote it herself, the wretch.
When we weren't looking.
You were looking the whole time.
Out with you, now. We're all going tomorrow night, but this isn't just a ball. This is when the prince must choose a girl to become his wife. It's tradition. To become king, he must marry, like his father and his father before him. And tomorrow night, every young maiden will be there.
Including me.
Including moi.
Yes, quite. But with two of you, our success is second to none. Now, what have I taught you since you can walk and talk?
Your skill's a masterpiece if you paint by the book. Inner beauty's nothing compared to classy looks.
Excellent, excellent. Now, what will we do today?
a manicure, a pedicure, and fine shiny shoes.
A lipstick of a color from so many to choose.
What to wear is hard to refuse.
Then finding the right style and choosing not one, but two.
And that's our cue. Let's shop. Cinders? Let's be clear. This invitation is not for you. Come, girls.
Look, it's addressed to me. So, she's envious. You remember the prince boy who came here? He was lonely then. What will he be now?
That melody echoes about the palace in a special way, my boy. I don't know where I heard it. Tomorrow, all the princesses of the world are going to be here in your honor. Are you ready to choose your princess?
Can we postpone?
No.
Reschedule?
No.
Forget it altogether? It feels so arranged.
I met your mother at the ball. And until she was taken from us, you know, we were both very happy. But that was because we both agreed upon one thing when we first met. Among all those shining dancers and diadems, we knew that happiness depended on a sacrifice.
What? Not to even like one another?
Oh, we liked each other for sure. Loved each other at first sight. Her beautiful dress. Her entrance on the stairs. Unforgettable.
Then what sacrifice do you mean, sir?
That our people's happiness must come first.
Everything they wanted.
Some help, please.
Is that all?
Yes.
Well, I make tea. You help the ladies in.
Why is it that the serving staff does not appreciate the difficulties of their betters?
Oh, I hope you have room for all your new things.
Oh, said in the spirit of pure envy.
Unadulterated envy.
Envy of the worst kind.
Oh. Not at all. I'm just curious.
I've already forgotten what I bought, but you must include a new hat. Let's see my new hat.
Cinderella, there's
my
boxes.
My new dress. Oh,
isn't that hat?
Oh. Pringle.
Oh, dear. That dreaded creature again.
My hat.
Is this a hat?
Not much of a hat. Oh. Cinderella. It's time to get ready for the ball. Bring those boxes upstairs, please.
It is the night of the ball.
Thank you.
no time to leave.
Is it? Cinderella, we're going to the ball now. Isn't it exciting? How do I look?
Yes?
Come, girls. It's time to go. It's so exciting tonight. Come this way, everyone. Girls, take a breath. Remember, you're meeting the prince tonight. And entree, stand up. Posture's important. Cinderella, clean the floor. And as a matter of fact, clean everything. Toodaloo.
What, dears? Oh, you've all worked so hard. But I must go to the ball. But I can't go. Ella! Ella, dear! There you are. Oh, it's been a long time, Godmother.
Are those happy tears?
Yes, and no. I believe in wonderful things. I really do. So with an extra little bit of make-believe, can a wonderful thing come true?
Something marvelous and mystical?
Yes.
Something weird and wonderful?
Yes.
Think what you're asking, Ella. You have a little dream and suddenly, what guardian angels rushing to your side.
It doesn't sound so wrong.
You cannot count on make-believe to make things real. Make-believe is only to help you make up your mind.
So, the way you explain it,
with a firm mind, you tell yourself,
if stepmother won't allow me to go to the ball,
when you're invited,
then I'll make-believe I'm going anyway.
Yes.
And that will tell me how.
Good girl. And how will you go?
My orange pumpkin magically transforms into a gold carriage.
Pumpkin. Easy. Go on.
My four little white mice into four white Arabians.
What a fun idea. And?
Oh, my little fox into an elegant footman.
Right. It's, impossible for a plain yellow pumpkin to become a golden carriage. Impossible for a young lady like you to become married with a prince. And four white mice will never be four white horses. Such faltero infidelity of courses. Impossible. But the world is full of zanies and fools who don't believe in sensible rules and won't believe what sensible people say. And because these daft and do-it-all dopes keep building up impossible hopes, impossible things do really.
Am I learning a lesson?
Come. It's their nature. Always on the twirl, spinning around,
woo!
Turning and twinkling.
Is it me dancing or them?
Oh, I so remember your father and mother at their ball. One condition.
One condition.
What else do I wear?
One condition.
One condition.
You must be back by midnight.
Midnight? Of course.
Oh, this lovely magic will disappear.
But fairy godmother, I cannot go to the ball just like this. We're only just beginning.
O ye, come forth, I command you. I shall transform you into a gold carriage. And it's not even your birthday.
All right, but it's a talking carriage.
No other kind. Now go outside and say, hey, presto!
Hey, presto!
Hello, four mice. Now go outside and say, bippity boppity boo! Pringle, now Pringle, go outside and say anything and come back.
Dress.
Easy enough. Where's your Gucci, Chanel, Armani, and voila! Woo.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the prince is having a ball.
My lords, ladies, and gentlemen, please welcome his most gracious majesty, the king, and his royal highness, the prince.
It's your evening, my boy.
Would you like to dance?
Thank you. this for you, sir?
It's all make-believe, my boy.
But it's so strange. Strange people. Unsuitable behavior. Awkwardness everywhere.
Certainly among all these beautiful people, you'll find a bride to rule the land at your side, my boy.
Oh, but they all look at me. And I cannot, must not look at any of them for fear of causing an upset.
Never mind, it's such a magical night.
A half past.
I'm just making a fool of myself. Never when it's such a magical night.
A quarter to.
Hello, miss.
I have no concern for cause. I have the best room in the dancer. Oh, I'm sorry. Hello, Prince. I can talk now.
With your fine prince.
By what? By preparing yourself, madam, for disappointment. You may observe Ms. Wonderful over there.
You charming man, don't you know that there's no such thing as disappointment?
Why would a fellow want a girl like her, a frail and fluffy beauty? Why can't a fellow ever once prefer a solid girl like me?
With a frothy little bubble, with a flimsy kind of charm, and with very little trouble, I could break her little arm. Oh, why would a fellow want a girl like her, so obviously unusual? Why can't a fellow ever once prefer a usual girl like me? Her skin's
not a pretty shade of pink,
but not any pinker than a daisy's. Her skin may be delicate and soft, but not any softer than a daisy's. Her neck may be whiter than a swan's. She's only as playful as a daisy. She's only as graceful as a bird. So why is the fellow going crazy? Oh, why would a fellow want a girl like her? A girl who's merely lovely. Why can't a fellow ever once prefer a girl who's merely me? What's the matter with a man? What's the matter with a man? What's the matter with a man?
Are you here with your family?
No, no. Not with anyone related, just myself.
But who are you?
Don't you know? You sent an invitation.
Ten minutes ago, I saw you. I looked up when you came through the door. My head started reeling, you gave me a feeling, the room had no ceiling or floor.
10 minutes ago I met you, and we murmured our how do you do's. I wanted to ring out the bells and fling out my arms and to sing out the news.
I have found she's an angel with the dust of the stars in her eyes. We are dancing, we are flying, and she's taking me back to the sky.
In the arms of my love,
something I said.
Look, Antoine, the time's gone.
I know the man for the job. I am the man for the job. Harold?
Highness. Oh, quite observant, I see.
Now, I want you to make a royal proclamation. Whoever's foot fits this glass shoe shall at once marry His Highness the Prince.
I say, Highness, she's a stunner. I mean, down to her very close.
I know her from somewhere.
From this?
Now go out and make a royal proclamation.
I go. I go. Look how I go.
Make a royal proclamation. Whoever's foot. Now everyone will volunteer their feet. Perfect. Disguised as a shoe bearer. I'll know her right away. All this make-believe to find someone real. Sir, I found her. Is she shy? Where is she? Who is she? I don't know. So I must find her, well, once again. So no one we know. No one. No sued by ambassador or special envoy. Not a whisper. No one even from a distant royal family. A complete stranger. Well, it's a pretty problem. As the champagne of love froths away and you look squarely at the one you love.
Yes?
Can she talk? Substance before beauty?
Well, neither of us talked that much.
The silence of the soul. And you lost her.
Wow. I don't even know her name.
You must follow your heart. Go out and find her. You better make a royal proclamation.
On my way.
Ms. Wonderful's carriage for miles, and I'm sure she took an illegal turn. And I do not regret for a second that I spoke to her fancy wheel with my bell.
No, don't, Mama. It's too distressing. You twirled like a bell.
Like a dog, Mama. And what a disappointment. What a waste of time with that prince. All looks, no touch.
Was the ball absolutely lovely?
Oh, lovely's the word.
And lovely's the time.
But for that dratted prince.
He
Delicious food.
Wonderful music.
Everyone gorgeously dressed, except for that dratted
Miss Wonderful.
Forget her.
Stuff on her.
When you're driving through the moonlight on the highway, when you're driving through the moonlight to the dance, you are breathless with the wild anticipation of adventure and excitement and romance.
A lovely night, a lovely night, a final night you know you'll never see.
Then at last you see the towers of the palace, silhouetted on the sky above the park, and below them is a row of lighted windows, like a lovely diamond necklace in the dark.
A lovely night, a lovely night, a finer night you know you'll never see. You meet your prince, a child.
She's a nurse.
But sisters, I really think I can.
Can what?
I think I can picture such a lovely night.
A lovely night. A finer night you know you'll never see.
And what is that shoebox?
Oh, nothing. It's my mother's.
Clean it up, Cinderella. Clean it all up. Girls?
Pringle, do you have heartache as well?
Oh!
There, there. All right, let's have a hug before Ella gets to work.
Going to fix the time in the parrot. I'll be back later.
You're a shy one. Pick it up, pick it up.
Yes, Sir Harold.
Yes, well, attention, good people. let the kingdom know that the prince's bearer here... Holy bloodlines, it's the prince! I mean, it's you! I mean, Highness.
It was a disguise.
Well, why didn't you tell me?
I don't have to.
Now, I don't have to.
Go on.
I don't... Nobody tells me anything. Well, let the kingdom know that the prince's bearer here bears a shoe belonging to a damsel from last night's ball. If you are the damsel who lost a shoe and the shoe successfully fits, you are eligible to become the prince's bride.
Damsel, last night's ball, missing shoe.
Well, simply put, if you were at the ball last night and you lost the shoe and your foot fits the shoe that this here bear is bearing, you get to marry the prince! Well, before all this madness begins, how...
I'm coming!
Move! Mignon, I demand to be seen.
And you are Miss?
Mignon, I am Princessa, from what you know.
A princess?
What's all this I hear about poultry shoes? Nothing must come between one blue blood and another.
One blue blood and another?
Princessa, you were not at the ball.
What do I care about one ball? I have given a million balls and danced at a million more.
But, Princessa, you were not at the ball. And the person I met, the woman...
Oh, I'm sure there were many women.
No, there was only one.
Only one?
You are in loss, then?
Indeed.
What did he say?
Then there is nothing more to say.
Well, as I was saying, before all this madness...
Hello, came, my boy. How is your search? Hopeless. And I cannot stop thinking about her. Can I ask? The girl you met, was she your equal?
Am I hers? That's the question.
It was much the same with your mother.
You mean she was a commoner?
Not at all. Blood blue as sapphires. But when I met her, I was fixing carriage wheels.
Of course. Miss Wonderful's not a cloud of silk on sparkling slippers.
No frills or fancies, no jewels or jibes.
She's a straightforward, sincere, and tangible beauty.
Well, hello. Whoa! Boo. Not too tall and fit in all the right places. And that's just about me.
You were not at the ball.
Don't hold it against me. I'd go to as many balls as you want.
Therefore, I don't know you.
He knows me? All this fuss over a shoe? For you, Prince, I'd go barefoot.
Kringle, she's seducing him.
Oh, he's taking her away.
Well, taking a break, we'll be right with you.
Well, I'm waiting. We can't go on like this.
Something must be keeping her.
Well, we need a place to hide.
Timing. Harold, breakfast time.
Highness.
I want you to go knock on this door and tell them we would like breakfast too.
Well, aren't we privileged?
Knock on the door.
Zelda, is breakfast ready?
shoe doesn't matter, will he recognize me?
Send us the door. Girls, breakfast.
Go on, knock.
Oh, he won't believe it's me without my beautiful dress, my wonderful coat.
Are you sure you're doing it right, the knocking thing?
See, there's a door.
Cinderella.
Madam, I'm busy.
Right.
Please do the door yourself.
That's it.
Toffee,
the very same, madam.
He's in?
Well, if I might. Oh. Well, good Lord.
Do you remember Mama? We have salty, smelling salts at hand.
Well, how do we do?
Weren't you looking outside?
Oh, not something I'd readily admit to.
With someone.
Oh, Lord, I forgot. The prince!
Breakfast time! Oh, silly me. The door was open this whole time. That's familiar. You were all at the ball.
Indeed.
Funny.
Isn't it time that we discuss our office attraction?
Oh, time indeed.
If I give you another banknote, will you put my daughters over with the prince immediately?
Let's hope it has better luck than the first one.
Very nice. Girls. 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 The time is nigh. When the prince puts the shoe on your foot, make sure it fits.
Yes, Mama.
Prince, Your Highness, I have a feeling that the owner of that shoe is in this very house.
Me first.
No, you're always first.
No, no, always after you.
Well, Rosemary, look at the feet.
Sit. Your Highness.
Shoe.
Shoe.
Foot.
Foot.
Too bad.
Get up! Get up! Time! Sit! Whoa, Your Highness.
Madam. Shoe.
Shoe.
Foot.
Here.
Alas.
Get up.
Miss.
Mr. Harold.
Madam.
Let's get this done.
Madam.
My foot is delicate.
Shoe. I mean foot. I mean shoe.
Foot.
Here. Oh.
Oh. It's almost fitting. It's almost fitting, Your Highness. Oh, I'm so excited. I'm so excited, Your Highness. It's not fitting. I never did anything.
I'm wandering around. tales can come true, it can happen to you. If you're young at heart, for it's hard, you will find, to be narrow of mind. If you're young at heart, you can go to extremes with impossible schemes. You can lie when your dreams fall apart at the seams, and life gets more exciting with each passing day, and love is either in your heart or on its way. Don't you know that it's worth every treasure on earth to be young? It's much better by far to be young at heart. And if you should survive to 105, think of all you derive out of being alive. And here is the best part: you have a head start.
Things are happening.